the object if, which is under consideration. So next time, of course, that's possible also to include time t, but it's not complicated. But usually we don't include it in our consideration. So then, so what is our idea? Our idea is to decrease the dimension. I mean, we want to kill the variables y, and also we want to kill the dimension of this matrix. So it's possible sometimes, not always, but sometimes it's possible. So this is, and after this reduction, we obtain such type of equation, which is whereas no y, and the dimension, then the leading term of L is the effective Hamiltonian, and it could be scalar, or it could be scalar function multiplied by. It is possible for many situations. So I will say when it's possible a little later. So it depends on the structure of the leading term of our problem, the symbol of our problem. So it is possible. Not always, but in many interesting problems it is. So we have in the situation when we have the time in our problem, so we have this type of reduced equation. And if we have the stationary problem, then instead of this time t and mu, we have just energy E. So it's okay. So, and then it is not the exact reduction, even if our equation is presented in the exact form, but just some expansion with respect this to small adiabatic parameter mu. So this is the goal is to construct first this effective Hamiltonian and then the correction. So this both terms. Then of course it's possible to present the method how to construct the correction, but in real problem it's more than enough usually. Oh, I'm sorry, this is mu also. I'm sorry. This is mu. Mm-hmm. Okay, it's a mistake. Okay. So next, please. So, and what is the goal. So we present our solution as I show you before. We present in the form like we present psi in a form like psi of minus e. This is gradient, yes, and x. This is x first, this is it. Second, and substitute in our original and multiply, and it is new unknown function psi. This capital, this is small. Yes. Then we substitute it into our original equation, and then we subscript eliminate this small function psi and obtain
this
the
way to the reduction, right?
Yes, this is equation. So maybe back, please. Back, not next, but back slides. So this is the ansatz. Yes, this is ansatz. Yes. So we substitute it. Yes. How to? Yes. This is like the standard spectral problem for the matrices, for instance. So you have two unknown object, four and just one equation. Two unknown object are this operator L. Yes, and this function, or vector function, something like it is analog of the eigenfunctions. Yes, so then the substituting in our original equation, then take the derivative first to second, and then we change it by this equation from this these terms change by this term from our equation. Yes, this equation, and then we obtain the operator. Next slide, please. Then we obtain the operator equation for psi and L. operators. And now the main trick is that we pass from the operators to the symbols using the Leibniz formula, which I discussed last lectures, which is quite very simple in this situation. So then after that, passing to the symbol, we obtain again the pseudo-differential operator, or differential operator, it depends on, no, actually pseudo-differential, but because it's this xi is, high is pseudo-differential operator. Yes, and so we obtain this type of equations for symbols of chi and L. Okay, then it's good to add, and necessary to add some assumption about the some which is analog of eigenfunction. It's not eigenfunction because the operator is quite, this is operator again, so, but it's similar, yes? So we must fix in some sense, and it is the assumption about the scalar product of this. So it means that we have the such type of equations for the definition of this xi, this normalization condition. Yes. So what we assume that the scalar product in our original space is corresponding to the scalar product after reduction. So this is important because, for instance, when we consider the question about the stability, if we don't compare the norms, then you can find many interesting effect which are not correct. So next, please.
Rafael, you are looking for a unitary operator.
It is like unitary. It's like actually it is a projector. So it's not unitary operator because we construct just some solution, not all of them, just some solution of our original equation. If you want to construct all of them, you must summarize. Sometimes it's possible, sometimes not possible. Well, we construct partial solution of our, or partial class of our original equation. So next, please. So what is about this L? So it depends on the property of leading term of this original operator H round. So it depends on the, so actually it will be the eigenfunction and eigenvalue of this operator. And so it could be, and it's not only the single operator, it is family of operators. And so that depends on the P and X momentum and X like on parameters. So, and then it's why it is necessary to add some assumption about the property of this L and eigenvectors and eigenfunctions of these parameters. And so it could be, in a simple case, the scalar one, but if it's multiplicity is not one, then we need to include in this L all these eigenvectors and with the same eigenfunctions. And under assumption that they're different. But if we coincide, then we have the intersection of characteristic or something like the intersection of terms, and so it is a change of terms. It is closed, but I would tell about it a little bit, just a little bit. So then in the case, then this is the multiplicity of L is K, then we have in L is just a leading term, is just a diagonal unit matrix multiplied by this effective Hamiltonian. Okay, so, but in more complicated case, if we have a change of multiplicity, we can use the same scheme, but we change this H effective by some new operator valued symbol, like in graphene, for instance, because we start from the Schrödinger operator, but then due to the intersection of term in graphene, we have the limit equation will be not scalar, but Dirac equation. Yes, it is why, because they intersect in the zero momentum. Okay. So what is important also for the future? The asymptotics which we construct could include caustics and focal points, and so it is not just a double WKB representation for them. But what is the good privilege of this representation? It's good because they include all these phenomena. You don't need to consider separately the domain with the focal points, domain with the caustics, and so on. So you include all them inside. Okay, next one, please. And now, what is the we have this type of equation, the equation which I show you, and now we have the small parameter mu and use the perturbation theory with respect to small parameter mu. So we take the asymptotic expansion. It could be sometimes exact, but sometimes not exact, but it's enough to asymptotics and actually to preserve one, no, zero first and sometimes second approximation. It's not.
There is no small parameter
because we maybe previous slides and, when we have the equation for this back. So we have this is, I'm sorry, it is a mu here, yes? Mm-hmm. So we expand the left side and right side with respect to this parameter mu, and it is not complicated because it's just a Taylor expansion, because you see we have here second and one. So the differentiation on the right, on the left side, and so it's just a Taylor expansion. So. Then we, it is perturbation theory. Standard perturbation theory with a small parameter. That's epsilon or mu. So. Then after that, we obtain the equations for the next and next and next previous. And so this is the equation for the leading term. So, and I put this eigenvalue of this operator on the right side because it could be matrix. So if it's, and then for the correction, we have the linear equations. So we just we put on the move the right hand side to the left, and then we have the linear equations with the, so we have the recurrent system of equations, yes? For the all corrections. So he high zero, high one, high two, but so interesting, of course, high F1 and sometimes F2. So this is the formulas for this right-hand side and the situations. And so they have the F1 is equal to this type of. And also, it is the correction which coming from the our original operator. Mm-hmm. Okay. It's possible to give the different form of this. Okay, all this this expression are very well known. You can find them in the book of Maslov, but maybe not in such a form because they Maslov he constructed his first double WKB and then a different representation, he presented a different form of this. But finally, this is, but what is the operator trick is that we do for all situations here. It is some. Okay, next slide, please. And now there is, we need to add some additional assumption about the behavior of this vector eigenvalue. It is more or less standard. It is standard for the self-adjoint case or symmetric case. But if you have the non-symmetric case, then you need to introduce the bi-orthogonal system, and that is similar. But you also can find you also can write down such type of correction. And then it is assumption. And then it is also good to fix the choice of the first correction in this case. And it is this choice could be presented in such a form, it means that your it's preserved this scalar product which I show you on the first step. So it is some okay. Next, please.
EK in the first line.
EK, it is unit matrix, K by K unit matrix. Because in scalar case, oh, Mish, привет, it is. In the scalar case, it's just one. So it is, but it's not. Okay, next, please. Okay, then if we use the self-adjointness of operator, again, it's not necessary. Yes, and if it's not self-adjoint, it's sometimes it's good to consider not symmetric. It is, but in just orthogonality condition, in standard Fred-Golm alternative, then you can find first this Lj in such a form. Of course, there are just some hook. Hook because it's a complicated to find Fj, but for j which is equal to 1, it is formula, they are very effective. So there are explicit formulas, yes, but for the correction, because it's to construct the second correction, we must find the first correction, yes, and it's not so easy to give the, to present the explicit formula, but for the first correction, it is simple. So then you construct this correction, and it is a correction to the effective Hamiltonian. And actually, it is the main formulas in this theory, because everybody knows how to construct the leading term. That is so just a you must take the leading term of the operator, construct its eigenvalue, effective Hamiltonian, everybody knows. Yes, but how to construct effectively the correction, it is different. And then, as I told you, when I read many physical works, then the half of the paper is actually the derivation of such type of formulas in some case. Moreover, people sometimes use the matrices or some explicit forms, and then it's quite complicated to multiply and then to check it and so on. So, but it's the standard formulas. Then, if we have the this L1 construct and existence of this L1 formulas, then we can construct the first correction in such a form. Yes, and it is important expression, because here we must inverse such type of operator, and if we don't include in our consideration all the all the function chi, then this operator is unbounded, and so this is all the scheme is destroyed. Yeah, so and it is important, it is big difference with respect to standard scalar products. So this is the one. Okay, next slide, please. Then it's possible also to construct the correction in this in the correction. So there are appear such type of function, and so it is true, it's good to use this in such a form, and then it's possible to construct the correction also in explicit form. So next one, please. Okay. Now, what is the main result here? The main result is first this L in this equation, or in for the stationary problems also this L, and so we reduced our original problem to the problem which have the dimension which is much less than original problem. It is not all the solutions, just some part of solutions. Yes, of course, if we construct we have the infinity many in matrix case, vector case, finite eigenfunction and eigenvalues of L, and so we have the reduced our original problem to the set of this more simple equation. So this is okay, and so then the problem which could be considered for this equation is the spectral problems, scattering problems, the green function type asymptotics, and some others. So, and what is we have this L has such type of, and to construct the asymptotic of the solution is the, we need keep or construct zero first, and maybe sometimes some part of the second approximation. It is not the final result, that is intermediate, yes, because we don't construct asymptotics. We just reduce our system to such type of representation, which could be used in the construction of semi-classical asymptotic, using some different method, but of course we use Maslow canonical operator. Next, please. So again, this is the correction, this is the again, I just repeat. So this is the correction L1. This is the presentation for the solution. And so again, hi, we present in such an expansion. It is important again fact that we need to have at least the existence of the correction. It is different between the leading term. If you want to construct the solution, then substitute it in original equation and get the small correction, you must construct not only the leading term, but you need to substitute the leading term and plus small the first correction. Then, if you construct even the leading term into the asymptotic solution into original equation, you obtain O of mu. But it's not enough to be sure that you construct the correct. So you need to add the correction. This correction play important role in all the justification and proof. And it is the difference between scalar and this type of equation. So please, next slide. Okay, now let's examples. So consider So this is the Dirac equation for graphene. So maybe I write down, so remind you that is the U. Here we have I. Maybe I make a mistake in in science, but actually it is so. Ooh. But moreover, we can add the magnetic field here, so it will be potential. This is a vector potential here. In incorrect way, we must have. Then after this procedure, we construct this type of effective Hamiltonian. So it was the system, Dirac equation. I can show you before, but maybe it's not necessary. So it is 2 by 2, the two-dimensional vector system, Dirac equation with magnetic field. And so after this procedure, we reduced our equation to the scalar one with a two effective Hamiltonian plus minus. So, and this effective Hamiltonian has such a form. So here, this is a magnetic field. And this is the function chi zero. And this is the correction L1. So you see that is quite complicated. Actually, the correction connected with the so-called Berry phase, and it is so it includes here. So, but it's just some calculations. It is not trivial because technically, but it is good to take in account the self-adjointness of this operator, and then some terms disappear without any calculations because you know that some imaginary part of this correction L0 is equal to zero.
So that is. Sorry, I didn't catch your last words.
So we have when we consider this algebra of pseudo-differential operator, we understand
when the separator is symmetric or self-adjoint. Yes, this means that the correction is connected with some formulas for the leading terms. So, and that is, we can omit them if you have calculation of the correction. So, because it's a very long calculations, and so if we take in account this fact, then you can omit some calculations, just construct this one. Yes, it's technical fact, but you see, sometimes the technical things are quite complicated in real problem. That it, first you can take a lot. It can take a lot of time to prove that actually this term is zero. And second, it's very easy to make a mistake. You see, that is it. So that is why. Okay. So this is the example for the. What does mean the Foldy-Wodehausen? I will speak a little. But Foldy-Wodehausen is derivation Schrödinger equation from the Dirac equation in four-dimensional case, but actually it is not enough to construct this type of Hamiltonian, but after that you must expand this Hamiltonian with respect to this P square. Then you have the Schrödinger equation type in this situation. But when and why is possible to do, I will show you later. Yes, so it is. But it's analogs of Foldy-Wodehausen transformation, and we published big paper with Grushin about the standard Schrödinger equation, and so it is a derivation of the Schrödinger equation from this. Okay, next one, please. Then some tricks which could be used in construction of semi-classical asymptotics. See, in the classical theory, it is well known that if you consider the stationary problems, you can find your original Hamiltonian to some other one under the assumption that the energy is preserved. For instance, if you consider the Schrödinger equation, you can pass to the equation for geodesic floor, just dividing the. So maybe I write down this trick. So this is P square, no, like simple geodesic floor, this Hamiltonian. Yeah? And this Schrödinger equation has such form like pi. And it is equal to 1, for instance. Yes, usually the geodesic floor, it is on the Liouville surface. But we can put the tensor here. It is. Doesn't matter. Yes, and then you can consider the Schrödinger equation equal to me. Then you can pass to such equation, and then you can divide by V, and it's equal to 1. And so then you see that this type of equation is very similar to this one. And so if you construct some solution of this equation, you can construct some solution of this one. And sometimes it's very useful in semi-classical approximation and analog, because you can use some other tricks and properties of this geodesic flow. Or, for instance, you can pass to the Finsler metric, or you can take the square root of this Hamiltonian. And it's for some trajectory, you have the equivalent description of this. Yes, G here is it's an artificial fact. It is not, but you, if for instance E more than V, this is you have two Hamiltonian system, and the trajectories of them are coincide. Time is different. Yes. But the trajectories are the same. So, and that is possible to use in the separator method. You can use this trick in for the differential equation, observed differential equations. Of course, the leading term will be the same, the trick is the same. But the correction, which is important to construct for construction of the asymptotic solution, amplitude, and so on. It is necessary to construct this correction. And that is so what you can see.
So let's consider this example. This is the, just a Hamiltonian for the holes and the electrons in Dirac case, in graphene case. Then we can rewrite this equation in such a form. Then we can take the square and the degree, the square, да, возвести в квадрат можно, yes. We take the square, and then you have the equivalent Hamiltonian corresponding to this two one. And it is much better than this one because it's smooth. And so it is, for instance, if you use the mathematical program, it's much more easy to construct a trajectory sometimes for this one and analyze this equation. Then what is this operator analog of them? So let's consider the equations corresponding to quantize the equation corresponding to H plus. Then we can rewrite our equation in such a form. We quantize these variables. And so this will be equation for this, the part of the solution of our original Dirac equation corresponding to plus, corresponding to holes. Yeah? Then we have the symbol of here is not good, is this a square root, is something not very isn't. But then we can multiply this equation by minus, I'm sorry, here minus should be minus. And then after that, we obtain the, and then it's possible to add some function j, but it's not necessary, but you can choose it in some such sense that the final result will be more simple. But at least if you fix that first here minus again, then you obtain this differential equation in the leading term, and then the leading term of this operator has such a representation like the operator which we, like the function which we have. And they use it in many problems. It's not the, actually, we obtain, starting from the self-adjoint operator, we obtain the pencil. Yes, it's not because it's not linear dependence on E here. It is square root, yes? But nevertheless, it looks like the Schrödinger type of equation, Schrödinger type equation with such type of potential. And it is very important for applications in many situations because the Schrödinger operator is much more better than the other ones. For instance, you can use the Stokes line in this situation and so on. You see, because Schrödinger, of course, it's not exact, but nevertheless, it's possible to use.
The last line looks so similar to the second.
You mean the last?
Last line.
This one, yes. Last line, and the, yes, of course, but we want to construct, but now we have not the classical problem. Good question, yes? And we have not the classical problem, but we have the quantum problem for asymptotics. This is just a perpetuating Jacobi principle. And this, when we quantize it, is just the quantization of this perpetuating Jacobi principle. You can pass from the equation, for instance, from Dirac equation, the system of equation, you can pass to Schrödinger equation in such sense. In such sense. Of course, it's not possible to do always, but for many problems, it's good. I only want to add maybe when we wrote a big paper with my friend Mishka Snelson and his student Kuhn Reinders, I said that maybe don't mention this quantum opportunity problem because it's more or less artificial. But he said, no. It's very, for us, it's very useful. And so it is good. So it is good trick. Okay, next one, please. We want to. Yeah, maybe I will say again. So we work, what is my one of our main points, yes, that we start from differential, pseudo-differential operator, but then they pass to symbols and they forgot about this original pseudo-differential operator and work with the function, with the symbols. Yes, and with the function, with the symbols is better, much better and easy to work than with the operators. You see, it is okay. So now I'd like to say about the different type of asymptotic. So we have actually, we construct the general situation and we have the small parameter mu, so-called adiabatic parameter, which connected with the different scale in our problems. Yes, but then we can want to construct some solution of reduced equation, and then could appear another small parameter, because our solution could be changed fastly. Yes, but this parameter could be not coincide, could be h and mu, and so when and
different size.
Yes, and so. Let's analyze our results from the point of view of this simple semi-classical WKB function. So we substituted in this equation. And the next slide. Then we use the standard, this formula of commutation of fast oscillation exponential function with the differential operator. But only we see that in standard situation, so I'm sorry, that, in standard situation, mu and h are the same. But here are not the same, and so instead of one, we obtain mu divided by h. If h is one equal to mu, then we have the standard situation. But here it is, the formula is correct, it's true, yes? But of course, if mu is less than is mu less than k, and so then after that we obtain, so this is no k, so we obtain this type of equations, and now we see that we have the equation for phase. And p is the derivatives. And then we have the transport equation for the a. So next slide, please.
P is the derivative of x.
P is derivative of x, yes. Yes, it's derivative of x. And now let's assume that we have such type of equalities, inequalities. Yes, so mu is less than h. And then h is equal to mu, and then we obtain such type of equalities, and then this is again small parameter, yes, and then maybe, yes, small parameter, and then we can expand all these terms with respect to this parameter. It's just a simple Taylor expansion. Next slide, please. And that is why we have assume that our S is a function which depends on time on in a linear. As a linear function. And then after that, we obtain this type of introducing the new variables. Time we obtain this type of equations. Again, we have the small parameters here. Next slide, please. And what we do actually, we expand our leading term of our operator, this effective Hamiltonian, with respect to p, to momentum p in this case. And so we have the equation for the phase S has such a form. And so we need in our definition of our L symbol, we need to preserve just the square, the first term, which connected with the expansion if with respect to parameter to variable p. So again, what we do? We introduce a new parameter and show that for construction of double WKLU solution, we could expand our symbols with respect to new parameter. And it is important fact which are used in many different situations and so on. So this is the new equations for the this parameter, if mu is equal to h square, then we have the, you see, not the whole symbol, just the this one. And the same they have there for the correction. Okay, next slide, please. Now let me. And so, if we consider the correction, we see that that part
for this type of solutions, some part of the which appear in the correction of in our situation, it's move to the leading term. So it is so the this, but nevertheless we still need to construct the leading term in for with per small with respect to parameter mu, leading term and correction, and this includes this different ratio between mu and h. So okay, so next, and but now we have after this expansion, so we construct the our approximation will be not a pseudo-differential operator, but a differential operator, because we use the Taylor expansion for the symbols. So maybe I would like to attract your attention to this term. It is like here we have something like the wave equation or elliptic equation, and here we have the correction, which is dispersion effects. So you can find the dispersion effect in such form. Next, please. Then the effect which I discussed before, it's just an intermediate one, because it is not a we don't construct still the asymptotic solution. Moreover, I don't want to construct them. But nonetheless, I would like to say with if we present our equation in a form which I show you before, then we can use the quasi-classical or semi-classical asymptotics. And we prefer, of course, the Maslow canonical operator, and it is one of the schemes which could be used for solving the equation of the first order, for instance. And so we have the initial data, then this initial data implies so-called the Lagrangian manifold and the function of the Lagrangian manifold. Then the symbol of this reduced operator is the Hamiltonian, effective Hamiltonian. It implies the phase flow corresponding to this, then we shift it, and function also we shift, and then they lift this object to our original space, and it will be solution. So in the case when we have the stationary problem, we must add some assumption about this Lagrangian manifold. It is invariant. Invariant means in one an assumption, a condition. It means that after shift of according this phase flow, we obtain again the same Lagrangian manifold. And does it mean that that doesn't move? The point on the Lagrangian manifold move, but like a geometrical object, they coincide. Okay, so this is next slide, please. But so this is again, I would like to repeat. Again, so we start from the differential operator, but then we forgot about them and work with the symbols. Symbols and dynamical system. That is some point in our consideration and calculation. So next place one. Then maybe some important remark that this is the change of characteristic that is no intersection. It is important, yes, and it is, but there are a lot of problems, a lot of them, yes, and so there are some old papers and books, Landau, Lifshitz, Zinner, then Kucherenko started, and then last paper of Masha and Fialkovskaya, yes, was connected with this. But it is a lot of effects. It is, depends on how does this terms intersect. It could be smooth intersection, non-smooth intersection, and so on. Yes, so there is no
lines of flow.
Hamiltonians. So you have Hamiltonians. You have, for instance, you have two effective Hamiltonians. There's one effective, and they have a function of p of x. Yes, and this is p of. So we assume that, or they coincide, then they have the multiplicity, the constant multiplicity. But they depends on p index, and so they can intersect in some points and then not intersect. And that is the problem.
You mean the
graphs? Yes. For instance, in one dimensional case, so this is the graph, and this is another one. Yeah.
So it could be smooth, but it could be not smooth, like in two-dimensional case, like it could be cone. Yes. And so it is an assumption. But it's a lot of possibilities, and it is not, it doesn't exist in the general situation. Okay, then, but sometimes, even if we have such an effect for stationary problem, actually we assume that is equal to some energy E, and then inside this picture we see that we don't use all the graph, but some part of them, and so we don't meet this intersection point, and then at all this theory is also possible to use. For instance, in graphene, it's such situation. Okay, then some maybe interesting situation. Then we have the intersection, and they are not artificial problem. For instance, in the wave equation, the Hamiltonian have such a form. There are two Hamiltonian. It's a wave which come to run to one direction and the opposite direction. Yes, and so the Hamiltonian has such a form, and so we have the intersection and point P equal to zero. Yes, so it's not artificial. It is a lot of such a problem. Then, in for instance, in the shallow water equation, we have additional term corresponding to the vortices. And so all of them, there are three intersecting P equal to zero. But nevertheless, and for another more complicated case, then we have the water wave. So we have again intersection in this P equal to zero. This case is different from the other one. And it is actually, it is, you could solve it. Yes, so it is. Okay, so next, please. And then maybe last, when I gave last lecture, one of my participants asked me what is about the proof and justification. So my opinion is the following. So this operator tricks and methods are very useful for construction of effective formulas, explicit formulas. But for proof, in general situation, it is not effective, because to introduce some special space, and so the estimation, in a general estimation, you much better to have to construct this special solution, substituting in the equation, and then show, for instance, that discrepancy is small. So the first step. Then it's for original equation, the space are not artificial usually, and that is, you can use some method to prove that the difference between this formula asymptotics and the real asymptotics is small. Sometimes not, but it's to prove the general theorem. I think it's very very special case. Yes. Okay. So thank you. Next one. So then there's examples. So I speak about a little bit, not about Oppenheimer approximation, but about, okay, next one, please. So let's maybe some special, some our last paper, it's not published yet, is about the orthogonal polynomial. I presented a talk maybe half a year at your seminars. But what I would like to say that, so we consider this orthogonal polynomial, but then it's important for me now, that Aptekarev and his covers, they show that this orthogonal polynomial, the Hermitian type polynomial, they satisfy to equation of the third order, ordinary differential equation. Yeah. Then if we introduce some small parameter, which is proportional to one over numbers, the orthogonal, the joint orthogonal Hermitian polynomials. Yes, so they called it such. So then we obtain the equation of the third order, ordinary differential equation. Yeah. But if we, so the symbol of this is the polynomial of the third order. It is just the algebra, it's described the algebraic curve, because all the coefficients are polynomial here. And then we want to construct the solution of this equation. Next slide, please.
Then the fact that the characteristic polynomial for corresponding to the symbol has such a structure. So we could eliminate, we could separate the one real valued root. So this is a picture, from, it depends on the situations. And so our polynomial has such a form, like you can present in the linear term, and then the quadratic polynomial. The quadratic, because here we have no the focal points, and so complicated terms. But here we have the focal point, turning point in this situation, and so it's an idea to separate this solution, one corresponding to the first multiplier, and then to the second multiplier.
Lambda zero is, can be found somehow.
It is, could be, yeah, of course it could be found, because it's using the Cardano formula, but it is in this case it's good to use lambda zero like parameterization for the other roots also. So next one, please. And so what we want to say. So first we want to separate the equation corresponding to the linear term. Yes? What does it mean? So back, please. So it means that we must divide this polynomial by this factor. Yeah?
Lambda square.
Lambda square, yes. But now, if we want to separate, to consider the equation corresponding to the second, then we must divide it by lambda minus lambda zero. And now lambda is an operator. And so what we quantize it. So, and when we divide this, our equations by the terms corresponding to these symbols. Yeah? Next one, please. And what we do, so after this, dividing of the operator, so the leading term corresponding to the symbol of the leading term has such a form, but of course main fact is a correction.
Your trick, algebraic,
even in the ordinary differential equation, it works. You see, like it's some story about Бор. У него была подкова дома, висела. И к нему приходили и спрашивали: вы что, вы верите в это? Он говорил: верю, не верю, а помогает. Вот так что. The same we have this tricks, you see. Помогает, да. Вот. Это моя наша Аня Цветкова, she did it. So this is the leading term, the correction for this equation, and the second is the correction for this symbol. So this is the all this thing. Next one, please. Okay, and after that we can construct the solution of this equation using the semi-classical approximation, because for the second part we have the almost Schrödinger equation, yes, and so we can analyze it using the semi-classical analysis and Lagrangian manifold and so on, but I don't want to speak much about that. That was such a picture, which is the potential for this Schrödinger type equation, like a double well, and this could be such situations, yes, and then this is the level cut, this is Lagrangian manifold, like for if level is this one, energy level in this one, so then we have such type of Lagrangian manifold, and then implies the oscillations. And so after this picture which illustrates this type of polynomial with
5.23.7.
Yes.
Why
5.23? No, but it is not just illustrate. Of course we can construct many of them, yes, okay. But it's just example, you see. And then it is the comparison with the exact and asymptotic formulas. It's almost the same. But actually, they work starting from the very small numbers, like 2, 3, they are almost the same. So it is a good approximation. So this is the trick, how to next place one. Now, what is about the quantum weight git, but in 2 dimensions, we have the 3 dimensions also.
You have some comparison to Dirac calculations, right?
Computer asymptotics and exact formulas.
You have results obtained.
Yeah.
Asymptotic formulas and results obtained by
some direct calculation. Yes, and then they coincide. You see, almost.
Oh, roughly coincide.
Yes, almost. Moreover, I want to say that it was great surprise for us that they coincide starting from the small numbers. For instance, for the this type of formula for Hermitian polynomials, I told you many times. So. It's very good coincidence for n equal to 1. You see? N equal to 1, but so, yes, so it is equal to 1. Then the mistake about 3%, you see? So that is maybe, by the way, it means that if the polynomial, Hermitian polynomial has small numbers, then we have the слипание точек поворота, да, точек congruence of, and it means that almost, yes, and then our formulas in terms of area functions, they work, and then so this after the слияние we obtain the Gaussian exponential function.
I have a question. Are there any maybe philosophical reasons for such a good coincidence? I mean, even you have your big parameter equal to 1 and you have almost perfect.
I don't know. I don't know. But it is, but maybe because this function is very good. For instance, if you take the asymptotics of every function, and find the first zero of every function, it will be the same if you take the trigonometrical asymptotics of every function and take it first zero of function sine of z to the 3 one. The mistake is 2%. Yes. So this is, then also maybe if you use the Bessel function and you can approximate it by the any function, yes, and then even for n equal to 1, the approximation is very good. See, it means that a Bessel function is good only for 0. Another situation, you can use any function. Yes, just. So many magic facts, you see. It's Arlen Michal Shelin, he wrote in his book something like that. So. Okay, so now we consider the waveguide. And so we have the small parameter mu here, like in Born-Oppenheimer approximation, and it is y. It is the y guide in such a form. No, symmetric, but it's not necessary. So we use the so-called soft wall. So the hard wall means that you add the boundary condition from Dirichlet or Neyman. But soft wall, you introduce the fast growing potential here. And so this potential organizes the wall in this situation. Yeah? That is why we have the two different parameters. And this is corresponding to the motion along the waveguide. And it is. Then, so this is a standard condition, Born periodic conditions, and so then we consider the spectral problem for this case. So, okay, now we use this substitution. Next, please. Substituting, and then using this form, we again obtain this type of equation, which I show you for general case. And then if we construct, so this is the leading term, this is the expansion of this projector operator and the leading term of effective Hamiltonian.
So next slide, please. Just repeat. Я не знаю, I don't know. Maybe. So, but the for the leading term, we can construct a solution in an explicit way. So it is just Hermitian polynomials. Then we can construct the potential. The effective Hamiltonian is p squared plus effective potential. So and then this, we have such a form for the it's exact formulas. So simple. It is easy to teach the students using this example because it's very simple and everybody can do it. The good students, I mean. Next slide, please. Then we can construct also correction, but I would like to attract your attention to the correction. It depends on p, on momenta. So it's linear function. Yes, but it's important for future also. So then it's possible also construct this correction, the second correction, but not only for when p is equal to zero, but it's enough for our goals. Okay, next slide, please. Then we have the such type of effective Hamiltonian with corrections. So you see that has such a form. And then we can construct the different type of asymptotic, which I discussed here. Yes, and so it is. But of course, it's the asymptotics. This depends on the behavior of this correction mu. So it's also could depend on small parameter. Yes, and then if we have the if. So we have different type of waves here. For if v is proportional to mu square, then we have the lone wave, and it is impossible to construct any asymptotic solution in this case. Actually, it corresponds Тань, посмотри. Вот это вот важный момент, да? It's important case. Then, so we can take h equal to 1. So there is no oscillation in the asymptotics, yes? But it's assumption about this v. V should be proportional to mu square. Then the limit will be, solution will be the smooth function. And so it is actually it's corresponding to the classical averaging in problem in this situation. Yes? Then the second case, then if v is proportional to mu, then h we can take something like that or in the neighborhood. And then
H is included roughly in P, right?
In P, yes. No, H not in, it included here.
Yeah.
P is mu.
Mu.
Okay. Mu. And so we have the so-called middle waves, yes? But maybe what I don't say before, that if we have H is equal to 1, then the lone wave, they require to include of this correction. The second correction in adiabatic approximation. For the oscillation function, it doesn't play a role. But for the lone wave, for the limit, it plays a role. And so this is the main problem, how to construct it. Yes.
In harmonization problem, you have
in classical harmonization problem. Okay. Yes, in classical. Okay. Yes. If your solution, the limit is the not oscillation function or smooth function. Yeah. But if it's oscillate, then it doesn't play a role. Okay. Then,
oscillations
view in the potential. No, this is potential or initial data. So if you have initial data, then of course it's. And then what is. So the short waves, it's if h equal to mu, then we just have this term and more. But it's more possible also to make h is smaller. Then, and it's the question. How we can, how long we can we use this scheme in this situation? But now we must take in account this correction. This is first correction and multiplied by mu. Yeah? But p after differentiation will be mu divided by h. And so if h is about similar to mu.
To four,
then it's this correction
will be big, and so all the scheme disappear, destroyed. So this is the, you can analyze in the correction, you can analyze the Remke, as I will. No, you can frame, you can analyze the frame of possibility of use this adiabatic approximation. Next slide, please. So there is a in three-dimensional case, okay. So then maybe the other examples connected with the, actually the something like the Green function, but for the Gilmour's equation also in the layer is two-dimensional, but three-dimensional, but this layer. Something like that. This is it. And this is x1, x2. It is underwater acoustic problem. So, but then we use the same tricks, but as I told you, we construct a special solution. But if we want to construct a more general solution, we must combine all the solutions, the solutions which we construct for the individual mode, then summarize them, and it will give us this like an expansion with respect to eigenfunctions, Fourier method, yeah? But we, of course, so we use the same tricks, and so what is important maybe, so it is P mu square. Nu is the number of the mode. So the number of the eigenvalues of the of effective Hamiltonian, the number of the eigenvalue of the symbol. Symbol here is the symbol will be here. Okay, symbol will be p square plus the derivative. So we have the Laplace equation or Helmholtz equation in the one dimensional case, so we can solve it. And then what we see. So
what does it mean? Thin layer. D is small, D2 is small, D1 is small.
So what does it mean?
Тонкий слой.
Тонкий слой means that we have the we have no the parameter, we have H parameter here and not here. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It means that if we consider the so we have this is the L zero and this is the D. So D is then after number is mod, no, but it's a good question. That number is mod, what kind of problem we consider? We consider the problem about the something like the Green function. So in the right-hand side, we have the function which fastly decayed function. Yeah? But then, as I told you before, so what we reduce our problem to the problem to the set of problems with effective Hamiltonian whose in the differential form, we have such a representation. But what is effect? So if this term is not equal to zero, then we actually have the elliptic case. And the elliptic case means that we can inverse our problem on the right-hand side, and it's play roles only in some small vicinity of the point where we have this localized right-hand side. Yeah? So it's elliptic case. But if it could be equal to zero, yeah, then we have actually hyperbolic case because we have the waves which has run from the this point. Yes, and so nu is a number, n is a, our original coefficient here. And so if you analyze this equation, you see that it has just finite numbers of solutions. It means that even we have the infinity many modes here, infinity many effective Hamiltonian, in the construction of far field, just finite of them plays roles. Another just in the vicinity of the. So for acoustic problems, it's important because you have a recept what kind of modes you can hear far or you cannot hear some. So that is finite numbers, that is important. So next one, please.
How stupid It's large and that small is different.
Where? Может быть, моя ошибка. But is it mu?
Second line.
This one.
Ah. Large, small and
small, small, small. It means that.
And then large on the first line.
Yeah, large.
На первой строчке это разные.
Мю, одно и то же, одно и то же. I'm sorry.
F большое, F маленькое.
F большое, F маленькое. F большое, оно вот это вот. Ну там после, да, после, тут нету параметра, there is no parameter, but after introduction of parameters, they obtain this type of equation.
Ну, то есть оно связано?
Оно, да, связано. Ну, у меня есть формулы, так сказать, да, их можно найти. Просто, ну, так, и так много. Ну, ага, хорошо, значит. Ну хорошо, ну в общем, значит, вывод тут главное какой? The main conclusion here, so the main conclusion here is that only even in spite of we have infinity many modes in this case, but nevertheless just finite numbers plays roles in this asymptotic analysis. Yes, because this is okay. Next slide, please. That's some other example, then we can construct in the standard Peierls substitution problem. So this is the periodic function in three-dimensional case. This is a magnetic field, constant magnetic field. And so this is the, we introduce Lorentz momenta, and then we introduce the algebra of this Lorentz momenta. And what is the new fact? That we can, our ansatz, we construct in the same form, phi. But here we have this U operator P1, P2, P3. So early we construct X1 and P differentiation. But here we can construct it, yes. But now we can расширить it. We can extend this representation, and then we can construct the solution in such a form. And so on. So it is also could be useful in this case.
Very special solution.
And very special, not very special. It is a solution which Peierls actually constructed. This is not special. It's a, okay, next one, please. Okay, now I would like to speak about a little bit about averaging. It is my last part. So this is some I spoke about. The names and about the methods. So next one, please. So I show you that if we consider the wave equation with the oscillations coefficients, then our effective Hamiltonian have such a form. Yes, and then we can use this trick, this method which I spoke about before, using the averaging situation. But the main obstacle in this case is the study of the leading term for this effective Hamiltonian. So for effective Hamiltonian, we have this type of operator, and we must construct the solution of the spectrum of this operator, which depends on maybe let me rest. So this is the wave equation, and here we have the velocity which depends on x slowly and theta. This is the vector theta 1 in three-dimensional case. So this type of oscillations. So the operator valued symbol in this case have such a form, and how to construct the solution of this, it's not so easy, but what we can do? We can construct the expansion of this, the spectrum of this operator with a momenta P, which correspond to the different type of waves, which I show you for the waveguides. Or construct the asymptotic, some asymptotics of spectrum corresponding to the small correction C we can represent in the form this function which depends only on xi or on x, and then the correction corresponding to the fast oscillations. And so that is why we need to construct the perturbation theory for a very well-known problem. And what I would like to say, so what we did with Grushin, of course there are a lot of formulas and that you can find in any in Gilfan book and many others, but the fact that it's possible to construct the next one, simple, but what we want to construct, we want to construct many corrections and for this operator. And we did it, yes, and that in such way that it's possible to realize in Mathematica. Next slide, please. So what is the procedure? So the following equations holds for in this perturbation theory. Maybe sometimes one of you could use these formulas. You see, you cannot find it in the, because we find it using the Mathematica program, such. So what we say, we construct lambda 1 and lambda 2, the first and second correction. First correction is very simple, but the second correction is not so simple, but the formulas you see there are more or less. So next slide, please. But now I would like to say what is about the spectrum of behavior of the spectrum in one-dimensional case of this operator-valued symbol. So you see, that is also very well-known pictures. They have such a form. And so to each of these modes, we have the corresponding effective Hamiltonian.
Dispersion
curve for periodic operator. Yes. Yes. And what is our assumption? Then now we want to consider the initial data with the different, for the wave equation, with the different type of behavior, oscillations, oscillation or decaying. And if it decays not very fastly, less than the oscillations, yeah? Then slow. Then we sit actually on this lead, on this term, see? Because these terms correspond to the fast oscillations modes. And if you have the your function is smooth or not very fast oscillations, with small oscillations. When we just have such type in the leading term, we have considered this term. And then what we do when we expand our Hamiltonian, effective Hamiltonian, with respect to momentum P, which I show you in the previous slides. Yes? And so the correction which we have with respect to P, it's a correction which we can construct using the formula for the perturbation theory. And we did it with Grushin many years ago. Yes, and that, what is the pictures? So this is the real one. This is the quadratic approximations. It is leading term and the standard averaging. But if we add the correction of the to the P, to the fourth order, we have this type of approximation of this leading term of to the effective Hamiltonian. Yes? And so, next slide, please. And that is the formulas for these corrections. So then the first correction, this expansion starts from the P square, the leading term, and the P to the zero power, and to P1 is equal to zero in this situation. And we have just this type of expansion. So then it's possible to construct the correction, but I think you are tired and also I am. So finally, we obtain this type of Hamiltonian. And so it could be used in real situations. And so this is corresponding to the standard averaging and not to the very fastly changing mode solution. Yes, and it is the boundary is mu to the square root of this small parameter. Yes, before we can use the limiting wave equation, yes? And standard averaging method. But after that, it's necessary to include the correction, which give you the dispersion effects. So next slide, please. So this is a formula. In one dimensional case, you can find this averaging, the solution on the cell, on the you can construct this simple formulas in this case, and then, but if you want to construct the correction, so you obtain the leading term in such a form plus p to the more power, but you see that we have interesting fact that you have your expansion have such a form. Yes, so this is p square and plus q could be constructed, but it's important the form. Yeah? But what does it mean? Actually, it means that you use the so-called Boussinesq approximation in this averaging method and some other one. But what is the some remark? You see that it gives ill post Hamiltonian, because our equation is the equation, the wave of the equation of the second order, and actually the effect of Hamiltonian is square root of them. And so we cannot use it for the asymptotics, we can use this expansion. But if we want, for instance, to use the numerical method to construct the solution of this equation, you immediately obtain the problem of ill post of this. But it is just some approximation. But if you use another type of approximation, it's a good Padé approximation, then you obtain the pseudo-differential operator, but then you can multiply your equations by this term, and you obtain so-called good Boussinesq approximation. So some remark, I said, so this is asymptotic if you consider the solution near the front. Mm-hmm. Yes. But if you leave the vicinity of front, then you have the fast oscillations, and then it will be ill post.
What is the degree of freedom in this trick?
Что?
Coming to Padé, what is the degree of your freedom?
But you see that this Padé approximation, if you take the expansion, Taylor expansion of Padé approximation, it's the same.
But it is not unique.
It's not unique, but it's not unique modulo of p to the четвертой степени. In this sense, it's unique. You see, so yes, it's. It remark belongs to maybe to Carrier. Carrier very good scientist. Carrier, Greenspan transform, and so on, and so. But he's not mathematician. But it's, of course, it's maybe you cannot find it in such a form. But if you analyze it, actually, what he did, it is he did this. Next slide, please. Okay. Then, so this is the maybe some other type of approximation. So just to say you that it's not just artificial things that we can use in a real situation, and so what we did in this case. Okay, so this is the wave equation with some other type of perturbation, and so this is three parameters I told you about: mu, then delta, and epsilon is the previous mu. Mu is previous h, and delta is the small correction. So it is. But if you take in account all the three parameters, you can actually construct a good solution in this case. I would like only to say that it's not possible to use the standard averaging method because you have the bottom and you have some oscillations. And the bottom also depends slowly on the variable x. So, but if you use the standard method, averaging method, and your result is a constant velocity. He is not a constant, it's just a smooth function, and so it's possible. Okay, so then it's possible to realize all this perturbation scheme, and please, next slide. And no, so this I discussed, this standard, the passage to standard communization. So the standard Gamonization means in this effective Hamiltonian you preserve just the pure square. It's the other term with correction giving you the dispersion effects. Yes, and so it's okay, next slide. So in more general case we can consider the Cauchy-Poisson problem with such type of D, and this is a picture. Next slide.
L is large, right?
L, where this is L is large, yes. So this is a picture. This is the bottom, we have some oscillations. And the problem that actually in the when we study the tsunami wave problem, for instance, then the measurement is not very often. So the distance between measuring about 5 kilometers. So you must have reached it, because if you don't know, even if you even take the nets with very little step, it is not impossible to use them, because you don't know the bottom in this case. So
but what is a good model for the bottom? Is it periodic bottom?
No, it's not periodic. It's not periodic. It's something like that, but it's random. Yes, but still, but nevertheless, you can use first this method to construct some formulas, and then you can try to generalize them for the random situations. So, okay, next slide.
But in your case, what do you
think? In your case, I show you. If you give me 5 minutes more, then I show you. Okay. Okay. So, if we consider this linear water problem, that's so-called Cauchy-Poisson problem, then it is two effects. One effect connected with the fast oscillation of the bottom, and the second connected with the real dispersion effects in the water, because it's not a wave equation, it is a tangent dispersion relation. And it's interesting question, what is the, when you consider the real situation, what effects, they could be the same, you see? And then the people say that the dispersion connected with the water, and it is not with the water, it's connected just with the fast oscillations. So it's possible to compare them, and then we did it. Next slide, please. So it is, so this is the, this equation which we obtained, it's ill-posed, but so what is where are two types of dispersion? One type of dispersion corresponding to standard dispersion, and the other corresponding to the oscillation bottom. So, and it's possible to compare, and that sometimes they include give the same influence on the behavior of the wave. So, next slide, please. And this is some pictures which realized with no dispersion, and this is this dispersion for the solution. I don't want to speak about the method. It is different type of rays, and it is fronts and so on, but it is the influence of dispersion in this case. Okay, next slide. But now what I would like to say, that is the question which Sasha, you asked me about what can we do if we have the random. That is, actually there exists some many different approach. I don't know that the strict one, but our more or less strict. And so, but we prepared a short paper maybe 7 years ago, but up to now we don't present the, we have the full text, but it's necessary to work with it. And so it's, but what we do, so we introduce some function which could be averaging oscillations. This is our function which we consider with Brüning, Grushin, and with oscillation. And then, and so I show you before the results, but now we want to construct a situation when we have more or less random oscillations. Yes,
F is random.
Yes, C is random, yes. Bottom is random, yeah. Then, okay, next slide. And then we construct some method of averaging. Actually, what we do? We take some functions and integrate our function. We take the weak limit. This function, weak limit with respect to this random variable. Yeah? And then we obtain... Но она случайная, да, такая. Но она непонятная какая-то. Как, ну как случайная? Она случайная, так сказать, как бы с математической точки зрения. Одно-то оно не случайное, мы берем одно конкретное.
То есть средние, да? Там,
И берем средний, да, вот такие вот. Ну, тут у меня уже времени нету, так сказать, да, и вы устали, и я устал, вот. Это отдельный разговор такой, довольно длинный, может быть. Ну, в общем, вот, так сказать, мы придумали некоторый способ, да, как вот это, причем он, ну, он похожий на другие, так сказать, да, но как мы делаем? Вот берем такую функцию и умножаем вот на c, и средний, ну, интегрируем, и слабый предел находим, потом двигаем дальше, 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 дальше. И получаем вот скользящим таким вот, да. Вот.
Просто коэффициент усредняем.
Коэффициент усредняем. Но не просто так, что вот так, а вот с некоторой функцией. Причем у нее размер, от размера результат зависит, так сказать, да, вот как вот. И,
это процедура вот. С учетом.
Процедура, да. Ну и вот, так сказать, вот видите, вот было такое дно, вот оно стало такое, да, вот, так сказать, да, вот, вот. В чем неприятность? Да, ну, дайте я уж по-русски. Короче, what is the difficulties? Because we use the geometric optics and then the Hamiltonian system. And Hamiltonian system very unstable with respect to change of coefficients. So then before, without averaging, your results are absolutely non-interesting. So that is not correct. And so that is necessary to make some averaging. So this is the next one, please. Зависит, да, он зависит от метода осреднения, к сожалению, так сказать. Но тут нужно смотреть, так сказать, несколько, так сказать, менять до тех пор, пока не будет все как бы, так сказать, стабилизироваться это осреднение, вот так вот. Ну, ничего не сделаешь, другого нет ничего, к сожалению, вот так вот. Вот, ну вот, значит, вот, вот предположение, что у нас есть вот такая постоянная часть, вот это есть вот. Которая, она маленькая, то есть предположение, но она действительно маленькая, там, ну как маленький, там параметр дельта, он там одна треть, там одна, например, так сказать, но все-таки не так, чтобы быстро прыгает. Вот, ну вот, в общем, вот такая задача получается. Ну дальше вот мы это все, так сказать, делаем, да, next slide, please. Вот, ну и получаем вот результат, вот здесь у нас we have the averaged velocity, then and it is some theorems. Что разница between the difference between the exact solution and average solution is small with respect to parameter. Okay.
But
this is average solution, the solution of averaged equation.
You just take an equation.
Equation and two different equation. Yeah.
Averaging,
yes, yes, yes.
And we can
compare. Compare, yeah, compare, yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Exactly. Exactly. Next slide, please. No, and it's some real bottom. Next slide, please. And so this is the result of this averaging. You see, this is it is the size of averaging. You see, then if we this is the good averaging, it is the
best. And the green curve doesn't.
Green.
Semi-classical situation.
It depends on the wave, on the wave. You see, so it depends on the wave which we can study. We want to like to study. It's actually it's long wave, so it could be taken. And, okay. Because but if you no, for instance, if you have the some ступеньку такую, some step. Then and it is not very small because it's about maybe 40 kilometers and tsunami wave also 50 kilometers. So it's of course we have your reflection and so on. But if you have some fast oscillations like 10 kilometers, yes, and so you can average them. Mm-hmm. Next slide, please. And so this is the averaging procedure. This before averaging, this is after averaging, and this is averaging in the Sechenia, the section of. Yes. So this is the real bottom. Next one.
And in this case, what is the typical distance between two oscillations? Bottom oscillation.
You see, it is random.
Yeah, it's random, but it's 100 of meters.
105 kilometers, but it's as you say, this several kilometers. Yes, yes.
And what is the wavelengths?
Wavelength about 50 kilometers, 100 kilometers of tsunami wave. Next and next. Next, this is the profile, this is fronts. Next one, please. And this is the comparison with the exact solution and with the solution of the averaged. And this is the difference between. So it is works, might That's an artificial example, but works good. Okay, next one, please. Mm-hmm. So, okay, this is some conclusion for the averaging method. And so this is, thank you very much for your attention. And excuse me that I take so much, much time.
I have some questions, comments, remarks.
I have to compare this with any experiment with this.
No, we are doing now, because it's about the problem is also it's good to compare for the long distance, and then that it is a problem how to make this comparison, because the rays are not stable. Yes, and that is the method which we now used. It's a variation methods, variation method, Fermat method. Fermat method is good for the Finsler metric, so it means that your Hamiltonian is not standard, but no standard, but is and then your variation method is the minimum or extremum of this such one. No? And so we use this method and. For the long way, and so we have the good correspondence and good comparison with the direct numerical method and this one. But it's just in the process. These guys, they come from Kaliningrad, they are Serezha Leblie, so Maxim Klimenko and Igor Nosikov, and so they constructed this method, who stood the Institute Shooting method. Пристрелку. Ведь там ведь как, ну, раз спросили, да, так сказать, что как получается, что... Все. Вот здесь источник цунами, да, здесь вот берег, да. И нам, в принципе, не интересно, вот где-то там на Аляске, что там происходит, да, нам интересно, вот как сюда лучи приходят. Их может быть несколько, да. Но если пристрелкой, так сказать, считать, да, то это очень неустойчиво получается. Гамильтоновая система, она не очень хороша. Вариационный метод намного лучше. И, судя по всему, быстрее работает. Но это в процессе, так сказать. Вот. Но, в общем, вот это делается.
Вот. Actually, you were speaking about different averaging homogenization problems, right?
Yes.
One of the problems you can switch off.
Ну я могу стереть. Да.
Okay.
Like,
in this way. Okay. Great. So one of the problems, well, we can write it in the following way. For you, it is a semi-classical problem, like write hx. If you have here h,
yes,
then you change variables, and after mm-hmm. having changed variables, so you write here xi, you get Laplacian xi.
Yeah.
H square, right? H small. Mm-hmm. H square Laplacian with respect to xi plus v of xi, right? So it's a semi-classical regime. Mm-hmm. If h is small, then here you have a small parameter in front of the derivatives, and this is the same actually. This equation is equivalent to the previous one. So you can say that you have a quasi-classical situation when you have slowly changing potential. Then if you add, consider the potential of the form double v of h times x comma x, then you speak about homogenization, right?
Yes.
That is your homogenization.
Yes.
And as about Tatiana Suslina, she speaks about homogenization. If you have the following problem, you have, say, x over h, x, where h is small. And this are... But it was treated completely differently.
It's not... No, it is not completely different. The method is working.
Обычная среднее. Если оно периодично по первой переменной,
ну,
то будет просто v среднее. Интересный случай, если ты поставишь перед этим v множитель единицы на h квадрат.
Вот тут.
Да, да, большой множитель. Сильно сингулярный потенциал. Вот тогда будет нетривиальное усреднение. Вот это интересный случай.
Ага. Это то же самое, что на самом деле написать h квадрат Лаплас плюс v от x делить на h,
да.
x. Да. А, да. Здесь, а тогда здесь, а у Сергея тогда получается h квадрат.
Ну, то же самое получается.
Нет, а то же самое получается, да?
Да, но только я еще сюда ставлю какую-то функцию, φ там от x.
Тета
вот.
От x, да?
Ну, тета от x,
а, да.
Более
это...
общее.
Ага. Да. То есть, понятно. Все, я понял. Значит, это один и тот же метод, да?
Нет, ну как, методы, мне кажется, не один.
Нет, один, сказать,
ну,
один и тот же класс проблем.
Ну, задачи, да. Нет, ну тут задач-то очень много просто, на самом деле.
Ну, да.
Вот там их, так сказать, ну, бесконечное число, конечно. Ну, вот. Но вот, например, задачу, ну, которую вот я, так сказать, хочу тут посмотреть, на самом деле, ну вот у нас есть вот эти вот термы, да, вот картинки там были, вот они такие, а здесь вот такие, да, здесь вот. Вот так, да, вот. Ну и на самом деле, вот мы можем поставить сюда параметр, вот эту v поставить в виде v0 плюс epsilon v, другой параметр, v от v1 от это делить на h, да, вот. И epsilon маленькая, но тогда
вот
мы можем...
Это зависит от x,
да, но вот мы тогда можем что сделать, так сказать, да, посмотреть теорию возмущений, вот, такую, что вот мы аппроксимируем это вот просто, ну, вот, параболами. То есть как будто вот нету этого слагаемого. Да. Это не Ландау-Зиннера. Вот. У нас пробоя тут нету, да, так сказать. Вот я можем такую...
Прошу прощения. Значит, V с ноликом и V1 это какие-то гладкие функции, да?
Да.
Вот эти кривые, это что такое?
Вот кривые это спектр вот этой задачи, если мы зафиксируем x вот здесь вот, да? А здесь поставим y. И вот это получается d2 по dy в квадрате плюс, ну, v она константа, да, и плюс epsilon v1 от y. Да? Да, вот. Ну, тогда, значит, вот...
А кривая, да, что такое?
Кривая — это зависимость... Вот это p. Нет, это импульс. Квазиимпульс. В зависимости от квазиимпульса, да?
Так она периодичность v1?
Да, периодичность, конечно. Ну, v от 1...
Хорошо.
Но она может еще от x зависеть медленно, но это уже, так сказать, другое дело. Да? Вот. Вот тогда получается вот такая вот задача. Да? Но ее можно рисовать с помощью теории возмущения, стартуя от случая, когда у нас вот это маленькое, ну нету, нулю равна. Да? Тогда у нас получается просто вот спектр квазиимпульса, не так устроен, просто параболы квадратичные, сдвинутые на период. Вот. Ну а теперь, значит... Ну, конечно, нет, ну подожди, не Ландау-Зиннер. А теперь, значит, когда мы включаем вот это возмущение, да, они у нас раздвигаются, получаются вот такие. Ну, это похоже, да, вот, Ландау-Зиннер. Но теперь, значит, дальше вопрос такой, что с одной стороны, когда вот у нас оно раздвинулось, мы можем написать совершенно явные формулы для...
Когда мы включаем
V0. Да, V0. Мы можем написать явные формулы для теории возмущения. Она разная, но можно единую формулу написать. Вот она, где вот далеко от этих точек, она одна, а здесь она другая. Но мы можем единую написать формулу возмущения, она, наверное, даже известна, так сказать. Я не знаю, но ну, я не смотрел, но, в принципе, можно писать. Но дальше вопрос такой. Вот мы это посчитали, а потом применили вот наш этот самый способ. Да? И вот, так сказать, вопрос о том, что будет ли поправка, которую вот мы там писали, да, вот хи 0 и плюс вот это h хи 1 или там мю хи 1, да? Вот при таком возмущении, будет ли она маленькая или нет. То есть можно на самом деле делать так, чтобы с одной стороны мы по теории возмущения решали, а с другой стороны ответ у нас уже как бы вот и есть. Да? Вот вопрос, он на самом деле не такой сложный. Просто я даже давал одному своему человеку, а он, так сказать, бросил как-то, так сказать. Вот. Но вопрос, мне кажется, интересный и важный. Вот так вот, так сказать, как мы можем ли мы с одной стороны, потому что эффективно же написать нельзя формулу, там их всего-то, уравнение Матье, там еще, так сказать, да, вот так. А эта формула совершенно простая, эффективная, так сказать, чтобы с одной стороны мы посмотрели, как устроены явные формулы, да, написали, и с другой стороны, чтобы они работали. Вот, так сказать, вопрос. Вот.
Гуслаев с Дмитриевой, это же ее диссертация была, вот именно
Такие, конечно, он смотрел, но то, что вот оно расстояние-то маленькое, вот да, это, что вот это возмущение.
Это зона, это и
вот возмущенное, вот эти эпсилон. Они смотрели, мне кажется, нет.
Нет, смотрели.
Ну и для задачи Каши. Ну, ну пришли.
Смотрели, это ее диссертант, кусок и глава.
Ну пришли, Маш, пришли. Может быть, я действительно забыл уже. Вот. Но вопрос, я хочу задачу Каши посмотреть. Задачу Каши, мне кажется, они не смотрели вот так вот. И вопрос на самом деле здесь такой. Вообще, так сказать, ну вот если мы двигаемся по моде, вот у нас есть главная мода, вот это обычный Шрёдингер, вот и двигаемся. А здесь мы же перескакиваем туда, но там не просто так, там формулы довольно хитрые. То есть насколько сильно будет вот такой наивный способ отличаться от вот такого строгого. Вот. Вот, а?
Ну я их, кстати, могу прислать, а второй я не поняла, с чем сравнивается.
Чего? Нет, вот... На самом деле, как ответ устроен, если вот мы вот такую ситуацию имеем, да? У нас мы попали на эту моду, вот мы по ней пошли,
да.
Никуда не делись, да?
Там функции вибера выбирают.
Там не выбор, там... там ну,
в принципе, то, что мы...
Нет, ну а теперь мы взяли, посмотрели, так сказать, вот, а теперь мы взяли и посмотрели просто решение, которое у нас вот... Не обращаем внимания на это самое пересечение термов. Это, так сказать, ну вот у Кучеренки там написано, ну, когда там можно делать. Так вот, вопрос в том, что насколько сильно будет отличаться правильное решение от такого вот неправильного.
Как правильно это определить?
А правильно вот оно должно по этой моде идти. Когда они близко, они могут перескакивать. Но тут, в общем, вот игра такая. В общем, вот, с параметрами.
Есть.
Ну, параметры, да. Но вот с ними.
Его надо сравнивать с малым параметром.
Ну, вот, так сказать, вот я забыл. Ну, пришли, да? Но может быть, я действительно, если это хорошо сделали.
Я даже диссертацию, нет? Наверное, могу найти.
Да. Ну, нет, ну я помню, так сказать, мало. Да, но мало уже теперь. Ну вот, ну, в общем, спасибо, да.
Ну,
за...
то, что.
Так, Саша, давай поблагодарим.
Давайте. Да, да. Все, спасибо, да. Да, я...